what I think is needed and missing in a lot of cases is the communication. Because if you're not talking, if you're not communicating, there's not enough understanding that would lend you that the dropping of the guard, the letting down of your guard, and to, you know, putting your ego in check.
What were your, you know, reboot? We're in the land of reboots. We're in the world of reboots and redos. Like, what was your first thought when you were approached about this project?
I remember the, because I think there were two or three before that. And yeah. I saw the one with Steve Martin. You know, I grew up on Steve Martin. I always thought he was a very hilarious guy. And I saw that one, all the chaos and everything. And then when I read the script, you know, for the audition, I loved the script. It was very well written, and it was very funny. And it had some really, it had a lot of levels, a lot of good touching moments. And when I read it, I told my agent, Susan Fincham, I said, oh yeah, I said, I can knock this one out. I said, I'm going in for this one. So I was really excited about it. And it just, you know, the material touched me. It spoke to me. And like you said, it touched on a more than appreciable amount of social issues that it tackled, in some ways a very comical way, and in other ways, very heartfelt way. You know, I wouldn't say very serious, but a meaningful way, in such a uproarious and a hilarious comedy where you can take a few moments and insert some of these issues that we face right here today and throughout, you know, a long time in history. So I was really excited about doing it.
What do you think that this script, these producers, this director, like, what do you think they got really right about the race issue in this film?
What I think they got right is, for one, having it be a part of the story. There are too many variables, in my opinion, and in my experience, there are too many variables to the equation of race relations when it comes to interracial marriages, raising children outside of your race, having an ex-husband or an ex-wife or an ex-significant other to not be the at-home person, but still wants to be a present force, how they may see it. And it's that there's so many different levels to several scenes, but each of those, they're stacked on one another where you can take them apart and piece by piece and see what real life is portrayed in this film. The thing that I think they got right the most is what I think is needed and missing in a lot of cases is the communication. Because if you're not talking, if you're not communicating, there's not enough understanding that would lend you that the dropping of the guard, the letting down of your guard, and to, you know, putting your ego in check and understand that it's not about ego. It's not about, you know, who's better or who's worse. It's about position. It's like I can't expect a linebacker to do the job of a quarterback. That's your job, and you're much needed and appreciated. You're protecting the person who's passing the ball to the person who's catching the ball. So when you have a mother and a father who are of mixed race, and you have an ex on this side and an ex on that side, husband and wife, they can come in, and if there's a level of communication and understanding and acceptance, then, you know, the world is your oyster. You can do so much more. But if you want to hold back and just hold on to your ego and say, no, I'm right, you're wrong, I'm better, you're worse, then that's just going to lead you to a downhill tumbling of just turmoil and more damage to your ego if you're not willing to let it go. So I think they got that right.
Download the Grio now. It's free. The Grio.